row. Thank you very much. And there are still a few seats around here if you'd like a seat. There's a full row right up here in front. It's available. Good afternoon. I'm Linda McCullough, your Secretary of State. Thank you for joining us today to celebrate the truly treasured Montana artist. The Treasured Montana Artist Program started 8 years ago by the Secretary of State's office. It is a program that gives us an opportunity to showcase Montana talent throughout the year. Today, we are lucky to have Phil Aaberg as our Treasured Montana Artist.
University tradition, classical tradition of universities, which has been going on for so long. Power songs, all these things are things that I've taken into my music. So I'm really honored to have this award. This is a splendid thing that Linda has done, and I hope that it continues with her successor. You can make them do that, you know. So thank you very much for this. I'll play a tune, like a tune called High Plains. Thank you. That was, of course, Shenandoah, and had a little story about that. I was back in my alma mater at Harvard, and going to Wyman Library, which is one of the great libraries in the world, and I had taken a really important class for me on mythology and on folk music. So I was kind of looking around for books that I had read when I was a student there, and just wandering around a pretty old building like this, and I went into, there's one corner of the place upstairs I'd never been before, and it was a room that was closed off, and there was a desk guardian, and you had to sign in, and it turned out to be the special collection of folklore and mythology. So I went in there, and I was looking for books on folk music, and particularly about the Métis, a culture that is not a tribe in Montana, but that should be, hopefully will be. Combination of basically Black Cree, French fur traders, Scottish, Irish, English, other tribal peoples who formed a distinct culture with their own music, their own dress, their own stories, their own myths, the loup garou. And so the first book I took out of the shelves, I opened into the first page, it was Oshinaga. And I've been playing this for a little while, and I said, "Oh, Shenandoah, thought to be a Métis folk song." So that's why I played this today. Now you can see over in the corner, this is the official state piano of Montana. This one is mine, so I have to bring this stuff here, which I'm happy to play. So I want to play a little bit on the official state piano of Montana. It is, have you ever seen that piano before? Yeah, that's right. They hide it. But I wrote a piece called Upright, which is written on an upright about this size. So I wanted to start off playing this, on this piano too. And upright, of course, I like to have a lot of meanings for myself. So upright, of course, is about the piano, the upright piano. It was also about me, who had been flattened by life's events for a while, so I was feeling pretty upright at that point. My kids were carrying around in the room, just laughing and having a great time. I wrote the whole piece while they were doing that. And of course, the other thing that upright means is to do the right thing. Very pleasurable. There's not enough room for it. So, pianos are a symbol of our dedication to human culture, especially big grand pianos. So, it would be wonderful to have this just sitting there. You can put a cover on it, brocade if you want, like a red brocade would be fine, red green maybe. But I think there should be piano here, and so once we get this started, I'll be happy to do two free concerts a year on piano in attendant. And this sounds pretty good, but it doesn't sound like a grand piano. It doesn't sound like a grand piano. So let's do that. Thank you guys for coming to listen. I know we've got cake and tea and stuff afterwards. Let me finish up upright on this piano. And this is a sample Steinway Concert D, a 9-foot piano. I think, they do make Steinways in the United States, right? Or Mason and Hamlin. We already have a piano picked out. it's actually my mother-in-law's piano. And she passed away after she was a great pianist and a really wonderful teacher who had to quit playing because of rheumatoid arthritis and all kinds of stuff. So that piano seemed to be great to have here. since I've just been in youth and spent a lot of time, I spent about a week there, not in high school, but thinking about amazing media history, which in many ways is the history of the United States, but also the history of the state. And there was a club there called the Silver City Club. And part of the inspiration that I got was learning about all these different types of music. I mean, Montana music is not Nashville country. It's something else. It's something bigger. It's something more inclusive. And there was a African American couple who owned the Silver City Club, and they had a little boy who sit at the foot, probably an upright piano like this, listen to all the great blues and the woody players, Stride players, and turn through. And they left when he was pretty young, went back to Chicago, and he loved the state so much that he took the name Montana Taylor. So he quit at a pretty early age, in his 20s. He had recorded about 24 sides. A side was back in the days when it was a 45 record, or actually an LP for 78. It was a side, one tune fit on the side. So he recorded about 24 of these. You can get them on CD. And he quit, saying, "My manager stole my money. My agent stole my money. My record company stole my money. I can't afford to do this anymore." And you know, that's probably true. Back in the day, African American man trying to get by. So his most famous tune was called "I Can't Sleep." So I figured I'd write it. This is called "The Dream of Montana Taylor."
This one was developed by Ray Kurzweil, who actually developed the first open heart surgery. He's a pretty interesting thinker. He also developed a way of for the sightless people who can work in computers. He's a pretty amazing man. So let me see. Thank you.
Sam was when the legislature comes to town. Comes to the Capitol. Well, I am so thrilled to have you here, and I just have to ask one question. Did you ever meet Montana Taylor?
No, he passed away quite a while ago.
Okay. So we have a certificate to give you from the Secretary of State's office, and to whom? It's in this flowery language. To all to whom these presents shall come, greetings. Know ye that I, Linda McCullough, Secretary of State of the State of Montana, do hereby certify that Philip Aaberg has been duly selected as the Montana Treasured Artist for the Office of the Secretary of State and shall be honored throughout the great state of Montana for his exceptional talent. In testimony whereof, I have hereunto subscribed my name and caused the great seal of the State of Montana to be affixed at Helena, Montana, the 15th day of June 2016. And we have the great seal because I'm the keeper of the great seal. And I love the great seal. I love everything about the great seal except that it's in regal colors of blue and gold, which are Montana state colors, and I'm curious. So, those of you watching your weight, it's a carrot cake, so it's a vegetable cake.